This is a step-by-step video for creating input-output assignments that are auto-graded in repl.it. So let's get to it. First, let's go to repl.it. I'm already authenticated with Google, so it's logged me in. Now I'm gonna click on my username up here and switch to teacher mode to get access to that. Now in another video, I showed how to create a classroom in repl.it, and so I've already done that here. And so you can create a new assignment here. I'm just gonna do a simple sum of two numbers, and then we click create. And you'll notice here there's three parts to the screen. And the part on the right, what it does is it's where we write the instructions for the students. And so we can just highlight all of this and put in our own, write a Python script that requests two numbers from the user and displays their sum. I'm saying replace, write your code here with your code, and so this is addressed to the student. And over here we can have a template or a starter code for the students, and so I'm going to paste that write your code here. I left it as a multi-line comment, so in case they don't replace it, it won't affect the functionality of their assignment. Now I have my screen on high resolution, so this is normally all the way over to the right, but click on the next button to get to more functionality. And now this is where we choose how we want to auto-grade it, either by an automatic unit test, I'll show that in a different video, or input and output matching. So let's select that here, create a test case, and then the test case we're gonna give it is, let's call it the first example, okay? And so now we put the inputs here, and so let's give it 3 new line, 7 new line to give it the inputs. We have 3 options: flexible, strict, or regular expressions. I really like the regular expressions, but if you're not familiar with that, I don't want to complicate things. So we'll just leave it at flexible, where you can, it is flexible in terms of white space and other things along those lines. And so what we do for the test case now is, given the inputs of 3 and 7, the sum is going to be 10. And so now this is the output. So notice we don't incorporate the input in there, and that always trips me up. And so we just put the output. And so we to reinforce students for giving prompts, I'm going to include a prompt here for them to use. Alternatively, you could just leave it at the sum is 10, or even just 10, and it would look for 10 there. The disadvantage is if a student printed numbers from 1 to 100, it would probably match 10 and say it was right for all inputs, and so that doesn't work. I like to use regular expressions and replace this with a regular expression to just to mandate that they have a prompt, but not mandate exactly what it is, because they need to be able to match this pretty closely. So let's create our test case, and then let's create another one, and we'll name this one random, and let's just say 11 and 13, and again we're gonna have this. It's very similar, but the answer is 24. Create it here. Now let me go back. I forgot to include examples here. I found it helpful to include examples so that students have a good idea of what to expect. And we could even format it such like this, so that it stands out and students understand, hey, this is what is going to be here on the screen. And then we're ready to go. Now it's, and then you can set the due date here. So let's make sure everything is working by switching to student mode or student preview mode. Now, it looks very much the same, except we can't edit this. This is how a student would see it. And so we're gonna come in here and we would write in our code to be able to do that. And so I type fast. And so here we have put in the code and we can run it here. And this is a little Linux shell, which I love. And we can just say, okay, well, let's try 3. Let's try 7. Hey, oh, look, notice what happened here. These are strings, and so then we could change them so that we make sure that we're getting an int. And then we could test it again, sure enough, and then it's 10. So now a student would submit, click on submit here, and we can do that too, and yay, it passed the test. Had we not changed that to int, it wouldn't have passed the test, and we would have been able to see that. And so, back to edit, now click on next, and then we're ready to publish it, and you can save it as a draft for later, or you can schedule it for release later, or we can just publish it to the students immediately. And there we go, now we have created an assignment, a new assignment in repl.it. Check out my other video where I create an assignment that uses unit testing.